This is an Arvin Model 956T dual speaker AM radio from approximately 1955-1956-ish. This just came in the mail a couple days ago. I haven't really had a chance to get into it too much. I just kind of took a look at it when it came, made sure it arrived pretty much in one piece. The only thing that I did notice, and I haven't even plugged it in to try it out yet, was the cord on here had been spliced. It had a bunch of, you can see it's still there. I pulled the tape off that was on there. It had a bunch of black electrical tape on it. I pulled the black electrical tape off, and then I found it was wrapped with what looked like a bunch of white medical tape. And then also, if you look on the back, where the cord goes into the bottom of the chassis, you see there's like a bunch of more of that white medical tape looking stuff. And so I haven't really wanted to plug this in because I don't know what it looks like inside yet. So I'm going to basically pull the chassis out and we'll take a look and see, but it's probably going to need a new cord before I really go too far with this. Okay, I've unbolted the chassis from the bottom and it should be able to just slide right out of the case here. It's pretty dusty in there. A bunch of crud up in there is going to need to be cleaned out. Let's see if I can turn this over here. Let me stop for just a second so I can get this flipped around and be right back. Okay, I've got it flipped up on its side now so I can look underneath and see what's going on in here. There's the tape here. And what it is it's got all that old rubber-coated wire that just kind of crumbles and falls apart. So I'm going to definitely have to replace the power cord on this before I go really any further with checking it out, seeing if it even remotely works or not at the moment. It's got I see a whole bunch of paper caps in there, and it's got this one big electrolytic that's got four different ratings on it. So I'm going to have to order some caps probably at some point, but I'd probably try it out just to see if it works once I get a new cord on it. I do have a schematic coming for it. So that will help me figure out what I need to do with it after the fact. But let's see about replacing the cord here. And we'll see how well it works, if it does at all. Okay, now I've installed a new power cord. You can see it's much better than the old one. Actually, what I did was I bought a new extension cord. This like one end goes up into there, and the other end kind of snakes down. I kind of followed the path that the old wire was. Comes over here to the bottom of the on-off switch right there, and hopefully that's going to work. So now I can put this back in the case and plug it in, and hopefully it will at least work a little bit, which will give me some idea that, you know, if it just buzzes, then I know it's just caps. If it doesn't work at all, then I know that there's something else. And hopefully it doesn't blow up because I did something wrong. All right, we'll be right back. Okay, we've got it back together here now. I wanted to show you what the cord looked like that I pulled out of it. You can see that that was definitely a blown circuit breaker waiting to happen right there. It was really in bad shape. The rest of the wiring inside the radio is that cloth-covered wire, so that all seems to be pretty good. There's a bunch of the insulation that crumbled off as I was trying to pull the cord out of the back of the radio. And now we're going to try plugging it in. Hopefully nothing will explode. The radio's off. Let me see. Where's the end of my cord? Right here. Oops. Alright, we're plugged in. If all the lights go off, then something's wrong. Well, it didn't blow up. Is it doing anything back there? Oh, I see tubes are lighting up in there. little bit. You can kind of see them a little bit right in there. Let's see if it does anything.
Folks, welcome to the Dennis Miller Show. I am the aforementioned Mr. Miller. Yeah, later
geez,
in the
it
hour.
Works. Holy crap. And there's like no buzz.
Because, you know, he's an American, and not just because he went to Harvard, not just because he was playing great, because he did it all in New York. So, do you go home to the Dell?
Hey, visit buymrfence.com. B-U-Y, MrFence.com.
Your home for the big show, weekdays 2 to 6. Sports Radio, WEEI Boston, WEEI FM, and HD1 Lawrence Boston. Time now for the Giant Glass Sports Flash.
9-4-3-2-2-1-8-7-7-4-6-9-4-3-2-2. I'm going to just make this announcement one more time, and if I hear from the guy after today, obviously, you know, whenever.
I'm actually pretty surprised that this doesn't have any buzz to it. That old cap's in there didn't look all that great, but it's still working. There's no buzz going on.
Emmett Tyrell about how he expects the Supreme Court to rule this week on the
Illinois, then to Utah, and then to Jersey.
It's not super loud though. It's got decent volume on the strong stations.
Playing the most from the greatest years of rock and roll.
It's who we are.
It's what we do.
WXEX.
That's cranked all the way. So maybe some of the paper caps are holding it back a little. Yeah, I can barely get that.
It's great for your cartilage. It even has powerful benefits to help increase your mobility and flexibility. But the joint supplements of today are sadly incomplete because they don't start relieving joint discomfort immediately. Until now.
People can come in off Long Island and go to this. And while it may feel to some like, hey, you're going from, instead of going home, you're going to the Mets, not the Yankees. They're a lot like...
Well, that's the Arvin... Model 956T. I believe that was what it was. It says right on the bottom here. We can take a look at this too. While we got it here. Oops, I got it upside down. Flip it the other way. There we go. There's a label right there. The Arvin Model 956T. I'm not sure if this is... I don't think it's ivory. I think this might be sandalwood. It's kind of a... Instead of an off-white, it's kind of a... beige colored, so I'm thinking this might be the sandalwood. Arvin Industries, Columbus, Indiana, USA. It takes a standard 5-tube layout. And it says to service tubes and pilot light. Well, there didn't appear to be any pilot light when this was working, so I may need to work on that. But other than that, it's working pretty good. I think that's a Union. Is that a Union label there? I think so. So it was a Union made radio. Chassis is RE392. And so far, it seems to be working pretty good. And so, there you have it. Thanks for watching.